La luz, la luz, la luz. Radia la luz, poder divino. Radia la luz para ese ser.
La luz hace la unión.
La unión.
Before using any candles for your spiritual work or magical work, especially the glass kind, make sure you wash them, okay? What I like to do is I like to soak them in warm water, and I like to add holy water, and sea salt. And what I like to do is I like to soak my candles and remove any stickers. So I place them in the water to remove any negative vibration, any energy that they may have picked up from people that have touched them. Also, one thing I want to show you is a trick that a lot of people don't really know. When you purchase your candles, make sure, see this thing right here? Make sure that they're in the center. I'm going to show you something. Center, center, center. I have one more in here. Center. Why you want this in the center? Because a lot of candles that you purchase in Botanicas, they often come with this little metal thing that holds the wick to the side. What this does is usually it burns the glass, breaks the glass. And this is a gimmick to let people think that they're being under witchcraft or under a curse. So always make sure that the wick of your candle is in the bottom. Before using candles, make sure you wash them. Remove any negative energy that they may have picked up from anyone that may have touched them beforehand. You can use Castile soap or black soap. In this case, I'm just gonna use black soap. So what I do is just add black soap and I give them a nice washing to remove any and all energies from anybody that may have used or picked up the candle before I have. And I always remove the stickers. I rarely use any candle with saint images, so always make sure to cleanse and purify your candles from any vibration or anything that they may have picked up from anyone touching them beforehand. And like I said, make sure you always pick up candles that have the wick holder in the center, never to the side. Washing. Now, after you wash your candles and rinse them up for a few times, you're going to make sure that you get all that water out of it. So what I like to do is I like to place them. You can see I removed all the stickers. I like to place them backwards just to remove any water. And if remember, I always say when you're going to a botanica and you're going to go purchase candles, make sure that the wick holder, that little metal thing, is in the center. That is a gimmick. A lot of New Age companies and botanicas, they put, if you see this little metal thing more to the side here, this is a gimmick. They want you to buy more candles from them. You know, they'll make you think that the candle broke because of black magic, negative energy, witchcraft, when the little metal thing is too far to to the side. Of course, the wick will burn close to the glass and it will either break the glass or it will turn into a smoky dark color, which will, you know, a lot of people will assume it's negative vibration, witchcraft. It's not. It's just that the wicker, the little metal thing, often the wicker's too much to the side. And of course that will happen. What you want to do now is you want to dry your candles. Let them stand here for a little bit and make sure they drain off any water that you can. I like to use the dry dusting cloth, the kind that they use, you know, to dust floors. I like to always make sure I use a clean one, and I like to dry them off completely. You see what I'm saying? Dry them off completely, removing any water from it. And then I save them until I need them. Usually I save them in the freezer or in a place where no one will bother them a lot. So it's not easy to do with one hand, but you see the gist. I always use the dry cloth. Any cloth will do. And I like to dry them off and make sure that I have them like this so that if they absorbed any water, that it drains out. Many times you will come to a Botanica and you will see prepared candles. This is the way I prepare them, one of the ways I like to prepare them. First, I like to add everything inside my candle. I'll show you how to do that. First of all, never use, we call these the hot dog things, because you can see they slide. So what you want to do is you want to make sure you have something that's going to grasp the candle nice and tight. To this, I'm going to have a pot of simmering water, and I'm going to carefully place the candle into it. Okay, making sure you don't get burned. What you want to do is you want to melt that wax. So after around 6 minutes or so, you can use your clasps, hot dog claspers. I'm going to be a little brave. I'm going to pull it out with my bare hand. You see that the candle wax melted. You don't want to melt it completely all the way down. From here, I'm going to start adding my herbs that I want. All you want is a pinch of each herb. You don't want too much. Now, the herbs really depend on what the intention of your candle is. This is the way I prepare them. And what I like to take is a, what do you call these? Chopstick. And I like to push it in, get it all the way around. Then get my oils, just a few drops, any oil that you use. Actually, that's a little bit more than what you want. Just a few drops. Then add a couple of different kind of oils. And you want to make sure, these empty, I think these are empty, but you want to make sure that your wick stays in the center. Be careful, because I'm going to burn myself, but it's the life of a brujo. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to center this wick, and you can see it's got all the herbs that I want. Add a little bit more herbs in there, a little tabaco. You don't want too much, just pinches. Candles in the water, you can place a plate over it just to protect it so that no water gets into the candle. This is called a baño maría, Hispanic cultures. So you just place a plate or a lid over the candle just so you don't get no water inside your candle. Like I said, you want to make sure that the wick stays in the center. Okay, so you have to keep nudging it to the center. And I'm gonna add a little bit more oil into my candle. Just get that oil in there. And like I said, with a chopstick, can't see, okay, there you go. With a chopstick, just get that in there. Get all my herbs in there, making sure that the wick stays in there. Now you're gonna want your candle to cool down completely. To quicken up the freezing process so that the candle gets hard again, you can put it in your freezer, like I said, making sure that you always center the wick. This is a candle for abundance, so I'm going to add some peonia seeds at this process. I don't know if you can see it, but I'm going to add 3 peonia seeds into it and let it freeze, or let it just get cold. I want that wax to be cold, and I'm always making sure that I'm centering my wick. A little too close, but centering my wick, because you want your wick to be centered as best as possible. candles. So you can prepare your own candles. You can make your own candles. A lot of image candles are actually a little bit more expensive than plain candles. You can make your own image candle. A lot of people, we have books of prayers around the house, images of saints. You can cut out a saint, add it to your candle. Here I have Tituba, Witch of Salem. Just in case people don't know, Witch Tituba, Salem, okay? I have a picture of Marie Laveau. You can use any picture of a saint that you want. I'm gonna use Ekeko just for this candle. You can have slips of paper with lines on them. Parchment if you chose. Okay, you're going to want to have a glue or a glue stick, scissors if you need to cut anything. Okay, you can also look around for prayers that you want to add to the back of your candle. You could add an image in the front, and in the back you can add a prayer. Let's see what I have here. I think this is a book of Psalms. Which, these are old, I won't cut up, but you know, there's a lot of these books that are just hanging around the house and just, you know, pretty much they're very old. So from here you can pick up any image of a saint, and all you have to do is just cut it up. Make sure that you use the proper color for the saint, you know, the color for the saint with the proper candle color. If you do not know, then always go white, okay? I'm gonna use this piece of paper. I have a lot of these strips. Okay, these are just strips that I just give to my clients when I give them readings. So I'm gonna cut one of these off and place it on my candle with the image of Ekeko as my candle is in the freezer getting cold again. So here's the candle. It's nice and cold. I added, I don't know if you can see, way too much oil. All you want is just a few drops, okay? But you can see I added way too much oil to this candle, but that's okay. This is just so you can see. You want to clean out this area. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the saint that I want to place on here. If I'm going to put a prayer, I'm going to make an Ekeko candle. So I'm going to place this Ekeko image in the front, and I trimmed one of these written, you know, note slips. You could put a prayer, you could put a psalm, whatever you want. This is your candle. This is your petition to your santo, to your spirit. So I'm going to put the Ekeko image on one side with the glue, and on the other side I'm going to place, because I'm going to write down a petition or whatever I want, or you can put it, place a prayer. So I'm just gonna do the last project, the last part of this candle. Okay, so here's the prepared candle. I chose to prepare a candle for Ekeko. I could have left it white. You don't have to use any saint image or whatever, but I just for the video, I chose Ekeko. In the back, I chose that paper. I need to add a little bit more glue to the corners here. It's okay. But I chose to use the Ojala, and I wrote it forward and then backwards. You can see, you can't see the wick in the bottom because I added way too much oils and stuff. Try to add a little bit less oils. This is a prepared candle. When a person does candle magic for anybody or a candle spell for anybody, this is what they should do. Not necessarily put a saint on it or a picture of an image of a saint, but really prepare the candle. After that, you've got to pray over the candle. Add your energy. Well, of course, I've added a lot of my energy. I'm going to light it. Let me get another candle lit here. I'm going to light it up with another candle and see how it lights. You want to make sure you pray over it, asking asking the santo for who it's for, what you want them to do. Okay, it's a little bit messy, you can clean it up, but you get the gist. If you want more videos on working with candles, let me know and I'll definitely do more videos. If you enjoyed this video, this is just something that I wrote. You could put a psalm, you could put a prayer, you can put a picture of someone that you love, that you want to protect. Someone, say a picture of someone who needs protection. You can put a copy of a pictures of theirs on this. A prayer for a certain saint that you want. This is way more, first of all, it's more affordable than those Botanica candles that you buy already prepared and that already have the saints and all that. You're giving it your energy, you're cleansing it, you're purifying. You got to make sure you pray. See that sparkle? That's a good sign. Pray over your candles. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit that like button. Please, please, please hit that like button, subscribe, share on your favorite social media, and leave a comment down below. This is Sancista Brujo Luis. Santo Sanse. Forgive the mess in the background. This is my dining room table, and this is where I do a lot of my work. I hope you enjoy the video. Santo Sanse. Show you, here's the Keko candle the following day. I'm gonna show you what it looks like inside. Never ever ever leave candles unattended, and never blow out your candles. So if you have to leave the house, always make sure candles are where you watch them, view them. If you have to leave the house, never blow out your spiritual candles. If you have to leave, either use a candle snuffer or you can place a plate over it. Just like that. Also, never purchase prepackaged, prepared candles that have not specifically been prepared for you by a respected practitioner of magic. You know, a lot of times you'll come to a botanica where you will see candles that have been pre-prepared and packaged. That, my friend, is pretty much useless and garbage. And never use a candle that you use for one purpose for another. For example, never use like a dinner candle to a saint, or a candle for a saint, distinguish it and then use it for another saint. That's completely taboo. Candles are a form of sympathetic magic. Traditionally, candles were created to give us light at night and to warm us during those cold winter's nights. But by themselves, lighting a candle just by itself, that's pretty much powerless. You need to prepare it, you need to give it energy, you need to, you know, dress it, and when you do so properly, magically, candles light the way to the sacred and aid in dispelling evil or negative forces or forces of darkness. Candles release our thoughts, wishes, and desires into a physical energy, in this case the flame itself, into the universe. So they connect the physical with the spiritual. Now everyone has use candles in some form of magic, believe it or not. Birthday cake candles, that's a magical candle. You know, so I'm sure everyone has had someone light a birthday candle and been asked to make a wish. But did you know that when you blow out your candles, if the smoke goes towards the north or south, it was believed that your wishes would not come true. And if it went to the west and to the east, then it would be more favorable and your wishes would come true. But we don't blow out our spiritual candles, you know what I'm saying? So whenever you leave the house, make sure to either use a candle snuffer or you can place a plate over the candle, okay? Anyways, I'm going to close this video. Just wanted to show you. This is what the candle looked like the day after. This is the trabajo that I placed on it. I prepared it myself.
I usually use emergency candles, but when I do use a 7-day candles, I like to get the just the regular colored candles. And then I like to put my own images of saints. I like to glue my own prayers, my own petitions. It you know, this is more, you know, those candles that have the saints, that's more like and prepackaged, prepared candles. That's what I call microwave brujeria, microwave witchcraft. It's for the lazy, and a real spiritual person will prepare it for you. They will prepare out of an image of a saint. There's a reason why we use the image of the saint, so that you know not to use that candle with another saint. There's a reason why we have, let's say, uncrossing candles, so that you know that you will not use that uncrossing candle for, I don't know, for like you're not going to extinguish it and then use it for like a love, for something for love. But traditionally, just keep, if you light a candle for a certain situation, you got to make sure it burns all the way down. If you didn't join this video, I also have a couple more links down below on more works that I've done with candles. I hope you enjoyed. If you do, please hit that like button. Please subscribe. Please share on your favorite social media and leave a comment down below. Sancista Brujo Luis.